Not all puppers and doggos are good boys. Some of them are fluffy but aggressive nightmares. Some dogs can cause all sorts of trouble when they lose their temper. Yet people are still brave enough to own them. From the American Bulldog to the Chow Chow, these are the 5 scariest dog breeds people actually own. Before we begin, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos every day. With that being said, let's begin. Number 5. American Bully Dog. The American Bulldog, sometimes known as the American Bully Dog, or simply the American Bully, was bred from the English Bulldog in Spain and England in the mid-late 19th century. They nearly went extinct, but were saved following World War II by John D. Johnson and his father, who worked tirelessly to save the breed. Weighing about 60 to 130 pounds, they are really beefy boys. The American Bully is a recently formed companion dog breed, originally recognized by the American Bully Kennel Club, or the ABKC. It has been recognized by the United Kennel Club, or the UKC, since July 15, 2013. American Bulldogs are muscular dogs with a wide grin and strong body. They range in color from white to dark brown, but are typically white in whole body color. American Bulldogs are typically social dogs who have a strong sense of identity. They are confident animals who may decide to prove their standing in a group by acting aggressively, but this almost never involves humans. They are obedient dogs who typically protect their pack/family, but have been known to bite people they distrust or perceive as threats. Even though for some, the American Bully may look intimidating at an older age, just look at how cute this thing looks when it's much younger. The American Bully is a highly adaptable breed, often acting as a laid-back companion dog in the home, while showing a zest for life and energy while outside. Many dogs, despite acting as lap dogs in the home, do well in sports such as weight pull and flirt pull. Despite excelling in such sports and public misconception, dog and human aggression is discouraged in the breed. During the early years of the breed, a wide spectrum of dogs was shown, many displaying physical traits of the other introduced breeds. These were penalized heavily by the registry, forcing owners and breeders of such dogs to create new means to show their style of dog without being rejected. Number 4. Wolf Dog. With a name like Wolf Dog, you just know these things must be scarier than the average dog. It's like calling something a razor snake or a poison bear. The breed is, as you can probably guess from the name Wolf Dog, a mixture of domesticated dogs and wild wolves. These beasts have protective instincts and can be very wild due to their unpredictable behavior that probably resulted from breeding wild animals with common dogs. In some countries, owning and breeding this dog is prohibited. When owning a dog is prohibited, you just know it must be a scary boy. Typically, they are medium to large dogs. A wolf hybrid is any hybridization of a domestic dog and any of the 5 species of wolf. There are a wide variety of types originating from the many combinations of wolves and dogs, and they can occur naturally or through a breeding program. This depends entirely on what dogs and wolves go into the coupling, but they tend to have long fur with white, gray, and black colors. While all modern dogs originated from wolves, the wolf is not a domesticated animal. Its nature makes them dangerous to humans, and this has been shown to remain true even when only half a dog comes from the DNA of a wolf. They can become aggressive and highly territorial, which makes them relatively dangerous when compared to dogs without any wolf blood in their systems. Wolf dogs are a mixture of genetic traits, which results in less predictable behavior patterns compared to either the wolf or dog. The adult behavior of wolf dog pups also cannot be predicted with comparable certainty to dog pups. Even in third generation pups, produced by wolf dog mating with dogs, or from the behavior of the parent animals. Thus, though the behavior of a single individual wolf dog may be predictable, the behavior of the type as a whole is not. The majority of high wolf content wolf dogs are very curious, and are generally no more destructive than any other curious or active dogs. Due to the variability inherent to their admixture, whether a wolf dog cross should be considered more dangerous than a dog depends on the behavior specific to the individual alone, rather than to wolf dogs as a group. The view that aggressive characteristics are inherently a part of wolf dog temperament has been contested in recent years by wolf dog breeders and other advocates of wolf dogs as pets. Number 3. Chow Chow. At only 45 to 70 pounds on average, Chow Chows aren't exactly the biggest dogs in the world, but that doesn't stop them from being terrifying. Small things can be scary too. Just look at Smurfs. I've never trusted those horrifying little things. Chow Chows are some of the oldest breed of dog, having originated in northern China during the Tang Empire. Their most distinctive features are their curved tails, which extend above the back and onto their backs, and the black spots and coloring of their tongues. Chow Chows are typically friendly dogs, but they can sometimes snap at people for little to no reason. When they do, their bites are not often too damaging and are done in more of a defensive manner, but their propensity to bite ranks them as some of the most common dogs to attack humans. Yikes. And to think, some people actually keep these little nightmares as pets. It's like begging for a disaster. Most commonly kept as pets, Chow Chows tend to display discernment of strangers and can become fiercely protective of their owners and property. The American Kennel Club standards, however, consider an all-too-aggressive or all-too-timid Chow Chow to be unacceptable. For that reason, many owners have attributed a cat-like personality to the Chow Chow. Chow Chow are not excessively active, meaning they can be housed in an apartment. However, a Chow Chow living in an apartment will need daily exercise to prevent restlessness and boredom. Upon realizing that exercise is a daily occurrence, Chow Chow will tend to be more assertive with owners in anticipation of such activities. This breed of dog has many strong, loyal bonds with friends and family, but the Chow Chow dog is usually overprotective of one or two main family members. It is in the breed's nature to be quiet and well-behaved, but it is also resistant to training. Chow Chows become very stubborn and attached to certain individuals as they age. This makes training them when they are puppies crucial because they gain respect for those who care for them. In order to avoid aggression and overprotectiveness as an adult, continuous socialization as early as possible could allow the dog to adjust. When Chow Chows have reached adolescence, they reject authority from any other owner who failed to earn its admiration. Aggression can be one distinctive behavioral characteristic in this breed, though while some are aggressive in nature, many are known to be easygoing in nature, sometimes adopting an aloof disposition to individuals other than their owners. Aggression, when it does appear, is often towards other dogs of the same sex, especially Chows. Due to their strong hunting instincts, it is recommended that these dogs stay fenced, leashed, and away from cats and small dogs. This is why it is crucial they are socialized early and consistently, in order to act appropriately with strangers. At first, Chow Chows are very hesitant in interacting with strangers. However, this problem can be avoided if the owners train the Chow Chow at a young age. And many people do keep them as pets, including many celebrities. Famous owners of Chow Chows include Conrad Lorenz, Georgia O'Keeffe, Sigmund Freud, George Duhigg, Martha Stewart, Calvin Coolidge, Vanna Bonta, Janet Jackson, Mario Balotelli, and a little somebody you might have heard of called Elvis Presley. Number 2. Doberman Pinschers. At 71 to 88 pounds, Doberman Pinschers aren't exactly the heaviest dog on this list, but they are far from the lightest. Doberman Pinschers were developed in 1890 by Carl Friedrich Louis Doberman, a German tax collector. Most examples are black with light brown fur around the feet, but some are lighter brown in color. They are highly intelligent dogs capable of being trained for a variety of uses. Under normal circumstances, Doberman Pinschers are gentle dogs with a lovely disposition. They can be easily trained to work as guard dogs, and thanks to their incredible loyalty, they can become dangerously aggressive should the need arise. Their attacks can be fatal due to their overall strength, making them a particularly frightening dog. So, they are an interesting case, because technically speaking, they're not terrifyingly aggressive by nature. However, they are so loyal that if their owner is dangerous, the dog will follow suit. Yikes! Dobermans are known to be intelligent, alert, and tenaciously loyal companions and guard dogs. Personality varies a great deal between each individual, but if taken care of and trained properly, they are generally considered to be loving and devoted companions. But again, like many dogs on this list, their potential niceness hinges entirely on the owner putting in effort. If the owner doesn't, they can become really aggressive little tykes. The Doberman is driven, strong, and sometimes stubborn. Owning one requires commitment and care. With a consistent approach, they can be very easy to train and will learn very quickly. Although they are considered to be working dogs, Dobermans are often stereotyped as being ferocious and aggressive. As a personal protection dog, the Doberman was originally bred for these traits. It had to be large and intimidating, fearless, and willing to defend its owner from attackers, especially other guard dogs, but sufficiently obedient and restrained to do so only on command. These traits served the dog well in its role as a personal defense dog, police dog, or war dog, but they were not ideally adapted to a companionship role. The Doberman's aggression has been toned down by modern breeders over the years. However, today's Dobermans are known to have a much more even and good-natured temperament, as well as extreme loyalty, high intelligence, and great trainability. Number 1. Caucasian Shepherd. And number 1 on our list is the breed of dog known as the Caucasian Ovcharka. This dog can grow very large, a minimum of 50 kg, or 110 pounds for an adult male, and with a long lifespan average of 10 to 12 years. This breed originated from Russia and other European countries, originally used as a guard dog for protecting livestock in mountain regions. These dogs are even feared by some popular wild predators such as wolves. The Caucasian Shepherd dog is an extremely independent, self-confident, fearless, and intelligent dog. It is a highly protective territorial dog that is wary of unfamiliar people. It is a low-activity dog, seemingly lethargic when not working, but noisy and intimidating when it feels its family is threatened. Although certain strains are more vicious than others, they are often very territorial and aggressive towards other dogs, needing early and careful broad socialization, as well as consistent, but never forceful handling. This breed can be a good family dog if it is well trained and socialized, but that takes time. That takes effort. And if the owner does not put in the time and effort, they can instead be volatile and dangerous. The ears of the Caucasian Shepherd dog are traditionally cropped, although some modern dogs are unaltered, as many people believe this practice is unethical and cruel. If brought up by someone with extensive knowledge of the needs of a Caucasian Shepherd dog, a dog should have much less chance of suffering from bad health. Exercise and playtime are important to help prevent obesity in this breed. Outdoor activities such as hiking, chasing balls, and retrieving flying discs can be a way to keep dogs active and mentally stimulated. Which of these dog breeds would you love to own? And which of these dog breeds would you never dare to own? Let us know. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen now. See you next time.